stay close to you while we om, and then I'll move back. The hands come to the center of the heart. This represents the balancing of the polarities, the right and the left, positive charge, negative charge, or qualities that are considered more masculine or feminine. The palms gently come together. The skin of your palms is really soft and receptive. So you can feel, you know, the pulse through the fingertips, sensations in the palms. And as we chant Om, imagine your awareness can dissolve past all those external subtle layers. Fear and whatever may be out there, right to the source of who we really are. Texts describe it as infinite bliss, this eternal state of being. Take a deep breath in. Like last time we practiced, I'll offer a different variation. So if you're new to the practice, please do the first stage that I leave you at. And if your body's ready for more, then I'll show different variations. And come to standing. We'll start with energizing or charging breathing. The feet are a little bit wider than shoulder distance apart, 10 inches. Arms up overhead. Slight bend in the elbow and a bend in the wrist. You can relax the hands for a moment. We'll breathe in. Imagine you can breathe in from the center of the planet all the way up your legs. Breathe up your spine. Breathe up your arms to your palms. And then we'll hold the breath and concentrate on the palms. And when it's time to exhale, we'll trace the awareness again back down the arms, down the spine, down the legs to the center of the planet. As we're doing do this, imagine that the very best is happening. So you're drawing in this nourishment, nurturing support. Arms up overhead, eyes are closed, breathe out completely, and inhale, breathing in through the soles of your feet, up your legs, breathe in through the spine, to the arms, to the hands, hold your breath, concentrate on the palms, and exhale, trace the attention down the arms, down the spine, down the legs, back to the center. Again, breathing in the very best. Breathe in, breathe in, breathe in. Attention moves up to the hands. Hold your breath. Concentrate on the hands. Breathe out. Attention back down the arms, spine, legs to the earth. Receiving and giving back. Inhale. All the way up. Hold the breath. Exhale. And lower the hands down. Eyes can remain closed. Breathe normally, naturally. And for the rest of the practice, allow the breath to be natural. Come to standing at the top of the mat. Offering this practice that it may benefit all beings. And the arms reach forward, up and back. Fold forward. Step the right leg back. Lower your knee down, look up. Step back into plank. Bowing down the knees, the chest, the chin. Bow to the earth. Slither forward, cobra. Downward facing dog. Right leg steps forward, left knee down, look up. Left leg forward. Reach out of your waist, rise up. Hands at the heart. Again, go back. And fold. Left leg back, lower the knee, look up. Plank pose. Bow down, knees, chest, chin. Slither forward.
downward facing dog. Left foot forward, right knee down. Right leg forward. Lengthen out of the waist. Hands at the heart. Good. Jump back, reach your arms up and fold. Jump back to chaturanga, or you can step back. Bring your knees down, lower down. Upward facing dog. Just the hands and the tops of your feet on the floor. Pull the hips forward. Downward facing dog. Good. Breathe here. See if you can bring the chest and the head closer to your mat. Opening up the shoulders, the ribs. Rise to the toes, knees bend, hop the feet forward. Rise all the way up, arms overhead. Gather the hands at your heart. Again, go back. And fold. Jump back to chaturanga or step back and lower down. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Breathe here. Stage one, stay here and breathe. Allow your arms and legs to begin to ground. It's feeling really supported. And those of you that want more energy, rise to the toes. Keep your hips as high as they are. Bend your knees, but try to keep your hips up, reaching to the ceiling. And then some hops. The thigh bones move to your abdomen, and the feet move towards your seat. Hop in front and back. Maybe you can hover there for a moment. Good. Everyone bring the feet forward between your hands. Rise up, arms overhead. Hands at the heart. One more time. Stretch back. And fold. Step or jump back. Upward facing dog. Open the chest. Downward facing dog. Stay in downward facing dog. We're working on the hops. The arms stay straight. The thighs come to the abdomen, the heels towards the seat. You might be able to hold there. Lower your feet between your hands. And open your feet, sitting bone distance apart. Soften the knees so the abdomens rest on the thighs. Hands behind the ankles, elbows behind your knees. Press your hands forward, forehead to the shins. If the body's a little tighter, make sure you keep the knees bent. Fastest way to progress is to have this connection here. If you can keep that connected, then start to straighten your legs. Close the eyes. And imagine you can breathe in and out through the base of the spine. Shoulders away from the ears. And the hands come down to the floor. Step the right leg back. Lower your knee down. Two 90 degree angles with the legs. Knees directly under your hip. And front knee over the ankle. Open the right arm back. Turn your palm so the thumb points down. Bend the elbow. Reach your fingers around your waist. It might just come to your back, that's fine. If it comes around your waist, maybe hold your inner thigh. The left hand slides down to your front foot. Push your hand under foot. Open your top shoulder. Look up. See how long the sides of your waist can become. Stretch to the sides of your waist. And those of you who want more challenge can sneak your toes back a tiny bit. And then straighten the back leg. The back heel comes down to the floor. Your back foot is on an angle. One long line through the spine. Good. From here, lower your knee back to the floor again. Rising up again, two 90 degree angles. The right arm stretches up. Elbow outside your thigh. Top hand in a fist. Press your fist down, open your shoulders, and look up. It's really
through the chest.
If you're more flexible, slide your arm lower. See if you can bring the armpit towards your knee and free your rib cage from your thigh bone. And the top hand can work to push this hand under. You'll get stuck under your seat. So you have to push here. Push, push, push. And when the hand comes under, you can reach around and bind. If you'd like, lift the back knee off the mat. And bring all your attention to the center of your being. Imagine you are inside a beautiful, cozy house, just watching conditions around you change. And then from here, lower the hands, turn your feet to face the side, feet parallel, holding around the ankles. If your back is rounded like this, bend the knees, and then lengthen the sides of your waist between your thighs. Hold the ankles. You can stay here. Move a lot. Dharma does a nice grunting sound to help open up the body. Or if you're quite comfortable there, reach the crown of the head down, lift the sitting bones up. You may even wish to press up into something. So you can lower your forearms down, press up into a forearm balance. Oops, try not to hit your lamp. We're up into headstand. Or handstand. Good. If you've lifted your legs up, slowly lower them down. Hands onto the hips, long spine, rise up. Warrior two, turn the front toes forward. Back toes slightly in, arms up. Stretch, allow the front knee to bend. Your gaze is over the front fingernails. Feel your awareness is even. Hands down behind the back. Open the chest, lift up. Fold forward from the side of your body, inside your front leg. The head is moving towards the ankle. Bend your knee a lot. Back leg strong. Press strongly through the back leg. Upper body relaxed. Very humble. The attention moves inside. And lower your hands to the floor, both hands on the inside of your front foot. Shift front and back. And bring the knee down to the mat. With your pose, you can lean to your right. The right elbow is in line with your heel. Maybe stay there. If you have more space, you can start to lean further. If that's too much, stay up on your hands. You may even need a little bit of support. So if you have a book or something near you, you can place your hands on some books, or you can lower down onto a prop, a couch cushion. Even staying here on the fingertips. Make your way back up to your hands. Curl your toes under. Beginners will do a regular step back to plank. If you want a little more challenge, this top foot will slide. Back leg is strong. Move this foot back a tiny bit so you're on the ball of your foot here. And then allow your arm bone to cross your shin bone. So there's a little X here. Shin, arm bone. Fingers are slightly in. Lean forward. Now, so you can see a little better. Lean forward, chest is open. Press your shin bone down. Drag your back toes in. And allow your back leg to lift up. And then jump back. Upward facing. Downward facing dog.
Everyone meeting here, downward dog. And continue to stay in breathing, downward facing dog. Or if you want to work on your handstand press, energizing the body a little bit more, you rise to the toes, bend the knees, thighs to the abdomen, heels to your seat. Maybe finding the balance. Staying in dog pose. And everyone brings the feet forward between the hands. Left foot moves back, knee down. Two 90 degree angles with your legs. If you have a sensitive knee, you can place a blanket underneath it, or you can roll your mat up so it's a little bit thicker. And open up, arm stretches back, point the thumb down, the hand starts to reach behind you, around your waist, maybe to your thigh. And the right hand comes to the foot. A little trick here, this knee, if you think of crossing it this way a little bit, pushing in, it presses the bottom shoulder forward. You can open the top shoulder. And breathe here. For those of you who wish, stretch the back leg. The back heel plugs into the floor. Relax into the pose. And look down to the floor. Lower your back knee again, right underneath your hip. Check out the ankles here. Left arm up. Hook your elbow. Elbow presses down. Watch what happens in my chest. It opens. Instead of staying here, push down through this elbow, lift up. Or bring the armpit to your knee. And start to push your hand right here. You'll feel like, oh no, it won't go. Just keep sliding it, slide, slide, slide. Once it gets around the seat, you can hammer it in. Reach your opposite arm around, shoulders open. Lean back. You'd like to lift the back knee off the floor. So all those variations, but you can still be here, hold this pose. And now again, lower the hands, turn your toes to face the side, feet parallel, knees bend as much as you need to feel the sides of the waist between the inner thighs. Reach your head down. If you'd like to press up, go ahead. If you want to press up into headstand, you need to have a nice tripod. So there's a triangle. One, two, three. The two hands in the head, not the hands close to your head. So if your head is down towards the floor, I'm going to try to move so I can kick this lamp again. Your head is down towards the floor. The hands are back, not here. Shoulders away from the ears. And then you press down through the fingertips. Lift your hips. As you lift the bones of your pelvis up, the toes start to come up. And the legs can come up. And relax here. Imagine you can go to sleep. Everything is balanced, steady. Keep the bones of your pelvis lifting as you start to lower the thigh bones back down. And everyone bring the hands to the hips. Lengthen forward. Rise up. Front toes forward. Back heel, back, arms up. Feel like a star. Stretch evenly in all directions. And allow the front knee to bend as you press into the back leg. An infinitely long line from the center. Come down behind you. Shoulders open, lift the chest. Start to fold forward, side of the waist along the inner thigh. Relax your head down. If you're quite flexible, you can push your forehead onto your big toe. Otherwise, keep relaxing the head. And find that balance, back leg being extremely strong and the upper body hanging. Now both hands come down inside the front foot, lizard pose, shift front and back. Lower your knee. Maybe stay here on the fingers, might even come up to your hands, okay? Wherever you need here. Or lean to your left. It's okay for the body to fall a bit to the left. The elbow lines up with the heel. Maybe the right. If both are down, open your elbows and work at bringing your shoulders and your chin to the mat. And close the eyes. The postures are meant to be steady and comfortable. It doesn't mean easy. So we find our edge, a place where we're just slowly expanding our comfort zone. And see if you can relax into it. Make your way back up. So stage one, stay here a little bit longer. Stage two, the back toes curl under. Take your upper arm and cross your arm bone across your shin. Okay? So there's an X there. Bring your arm bone across the shin, hands down. Open your chest, pull the right toes back. Whoops. Push your shin down into your arms, drag your back toes in. And then lift your back leg up, concentrate. And then everyone make your way back, chaturanga, upward facing, downward facing dog. Head towards the mat. There was like a way I could see all little pictures of you practicing to give you some tips. Someone says hello. All right. So walk or hop your way forward. The feet come back forward. Feet are sitting bone distance apart. The knees bent. Again, you can hold the back of your ankles. Hide the elbows. Or you can grab opposite elbows and slide them down. Or if you're a little more open, stork, the arms reach around, and then your hands come forward through your legs. Okay? So your shoulders are on the outside of your legs, not the inside. Hands come forward. First, you'll grab your chin, then reach for the cheeks, the ears, maybe the back of your head. And the last step is to push your elbows forward. Hold back. Behind you. Whatever variation you're in, close the eyes. Receiving breath through all the pores of the skin and releasing through all the pores of the skin. This is the body's meant to receive information through all the pores and release. Lower your hands. Right foot steps back. Lower the knee again. Uncurl your toes this time. Stage one, come here again. Allow the hips to sink down. If you can, feel your back thigh bone is rotating slightly in, the opposite of ballet. Stage two, you push the top of your foot down. Lift the knee up. Feel the inner ears floating up. Next stage, the arms come up overhead, stretch your arms up. Soften the eyes. And lower the knees down
Everyone lift your rib cage up. Wiggle so that the upper arm bones are behind your ears. Gently reach up and back. Hips are moving to the front heel. The rib cage is opening. Lengthen back. Offer the pose. Long, clear line through your arms. If you're a little more open, you may wish to draw the back foot to your seat. You can slide the toes to the elbow crease. And then maybe interlace your fingers. And put this t-shirt over your head. Push your head back. Broaden from the center of your chest. Feel it stern and widening. Right hands come down. Step back. Chaturanga, lower down. Remember, the knees can come down if you need. Upward facing dog or just cobra. Downward facing dog. Head and the chest lengthening towards the mat, opening the shoulders. So opening the shoulders here, this long curve through our spine that we're doing now is the same that we're going to be doing next in this pose again on the other side. Now walk or hop the feet forward between your hands. Step the left leg back. Lower the knee. Stage one, up on your fingers. Hands on your thigh. Or remember, you can have some kind of homemade props here so your hands are supported on a coffee table and a couch or whatever you have. Next stage, push the top of your foot down. Lift the kneecap up. Watch the spine, feel hips, ribs, ears, one line. Arms up, stretch. And lower your knee down, and then everyone reach your arms up overhead. Open your ribs and lengthen the ribcage away from your hips. Hips move forward to your heels. Keep reaching your ribs up and back. You can stay there or open up to the side. So when you open here, your shoulder comes closer to your foot. This helps you to bring your back foot in. And then hook your toes over the elbow crease. Interlace the fingers. Arms overhead. Remember, you can be here. You can be here. You can be here. Here. Releasing hip flexors. Place your hands down. Step back to plank pose. Left knee lowers down to the floor. Move to the left hand, left knee. The left foot will come behind you. Side plank. Watch the shoulder. Don't sink here. Push the floor away. Feel like you're stretching evenly from the center of the heart. Long line. That's for stage one. Stage two, you'll bring your left hand to the center of the mat under your chest. Top foot comes behind. And the bottom toes turn to a 45 degree angle. So my foot is flat. My hips aren't facing the side anymore. Open your hips to face the ceiling. Lift your seat. Reach your fingers up. This shoulder moves into your back. And then all the weight starts to come onto your left foot. You can reach your right toes up. Hold your right knee. Or stretch up, find your foot. It's very normal to be wiggly here at first. And see if you can train your body not to give up on the first wiggle. Feel it and keep going.
Change sides. Come back to plank. Right hand center of the chest. Either modified side plank, the shin is down. And feel a beautiful line. So right here, the spiritual heart's the center of the chest. Feel that that light is extending through the arms, extending through your spine. Imagine you're making a beautiful light show here. Stay, offer the shape. If you want to come up, the top foot comes behind, the bottom toes 45 degrees. Make sure your hips face the ceiling. Lift your hips, shoulder and your back, fingers up. And hold the knee or find your toes. And offer your effort. So we don't do challenging postures because making silly shapes makes us more valuable. We do them to expand the limitations of our mind. So our capacity to keep going when things are difficult. Improve our willpower. And just stay connected to what really matters to us, no matter what is happening. Lots of obstacles will try to push us off. Lower down, child's pose. Sit on the heels, relax your head to the floor. Breathe through the skin of your back. Great. So come to a seated position. If you have a sensitive back, keep your feet down, you can hug around your legs, and work at lengthening your spine. Pull your hands forward towards you, open your shoulders, and sit up tall. Try to feel the sitting bones are pressing down, the spine is lengthening up. If your back is okay, if it's comfortable, you can bring your feet up to bow, arms in front, or you might be able to stretch them. Arms up. Lower your legs down, lift them up. Lower down and lift, or with bent knees, down and lift, down. Keep going, or you're holding here. Okay. Five more. Four. Three. Tapas, willpower, two. Last one. Good, lower your legs, roll back, shoulder stand. Oops, you might have to take your ponytail out for this one. So half shoulder stand is holding the lower back, elbows as close as possible, and there's a 45 or a 90 degree angle from your torso to your legs. Full shoulder stand, the hands come towards the upper back, working at creating a straight line. And if you have an injury in your neck, do legs up the wall instead. So if you're not near a wall, you can reach your feet up here. Relax. Near a wall, come into fetal position right by the wall. So bring your seat to the wall and then roll on your back. Relax the legs up. Whichever variation you're in, focus on the space between your eyebrows. In order to open the inner eye, the outer eyes need to close. Imagine you can feel or see a beautiful flower there. And keep your attention on the flower. Slowly lower your toes to the floor overhead. Keep your hands on the back unless your toes touch the floor. If the toes touch, you can interlace the fingers. You might wish to bend the knees and hug around the backs of your legs. And those of you with your legs up here, you can come into happy baby now. Hold the inner or outer edge of your feet. Roll side to side. Meditation is the same, concentrating on the space between the eyebrows. And imagine you can see a lotus flower there. tension remains there as everyone lowers down into Shavasana. Relax your legs, thighs fall apart, palms are turned up. And let everything go. Imagine you can breathe in through all the pores of your skin. Soften the skin as you breathe out. Allowing the body to receive breath and release breath without any attachment, without any fear, feeling held by the earth. Supported in mysterious ways that we can't see. Trusting in that. Legs slowly come together. Preparing for fish, roll your body side to side. Bring the forearms underneath your seat. Shoulders come closer together, elbows closer together. And bend the elbows, lift the chest, look at your toes. Open the shoulders, place the top of the head on the floor. And continue to focus between the eyebrows, imagining the flower there. And again, those of you with sensitive necks, prop up onto your forearms instead. Try to feel that the elbow is under the shoulders, the chest is lifted. You can keep your chin forward. Or if it becomes comfortable, keep the sternum rising, drop the head back. And lift your head, relax down, Shavasana. Everything melts. Feel everything turning off. Bend the knees. Place your feet sitting bone distance apart on the floor. Feet are parallel. Hands reach towards the feet. Press the feet down, lift the hips. Maybe walk your shoulders closer together under your body. Close the eyes. So you're gently pressing down through the shoulders and the back of your skull. And then the four corners of your feet. Stay here. And those of you that are comfortable, turn your palms up. Bend your elbows to bring the fingertips beside your ears. And then push down through your fingertips. Slide the top of your head towards your feet. Come up to the top of your head. I'll show you that again. From here, the fingers push down. It's okay for the heels to lift up. Press the fingers down and move your head towards your feet. And you can turn your hands so the fingers point to the shoulders. Stretch your arms and your legs. Either staying in bridge pose or coming up into upward facing bow. When you need to rest, come down for a couple breaths and then come back up again. Make sure the majority of the time you're in the postures. Learning to relax in the postures. Relax during activity. Let everyone make your way down, melt into Shavasana again. Legs together, stretch the arms overhead. Reach through your fingers and toes, stretch, stretch. Exhale. Hug the knees to the chest. And start to roll back and forth, unless it bothers your spine. If it's comfortable, roll back and forward. Maybe the toes come all the way to the floor and then your head comes down. Imagine you're a Muppet, just flopping back and forth. Inhale back, exhale up. Okay, the next time you come up, stay up. The knees are bent. Hold behind the thighs, shoulders open, lift your chest. Bring the abdomen to the thighs. Reach your hands towards your feet. Relax the head down. If you can keep your stomach and legs connected, start to straighten the legs. Otherwise, keep them bent. If you're all the way down, you can stretch your arms. Hold your hand, your wrist behind your ankles. And once again, imagine you can breathe in and out through the base of your spine. Imagine that the breath is a reddish-orange color. Bringing nurturing to your roots, to your legs, base of the spine. Lengthen the spine forward, rise up. Hands come behind you, point your fingers towards the back. Let's turn the fingers back, shoulders open. If you're quite strong, the legs can stay straight. Otherwise, bend the knees, feet parallel. Press down through the hands and the feet, hips rise. Show you're not here, chest open, hips up. Drop the head back, Bhastrika. Sniffing in and out your nose really fast, like a panting dog. Keep going, focus on your navel. Lower the hips down. Extend the legs in front. The right knee bends. Place your right foot on the inside of your left thigh. If you have a half lotus pose, bring your right foot into half lotus. The heel is under your belly button. So those of you with the foot on the inner thigh, the right hand comes behind you. Left palm up. Push with the left and twist. Those of you who are in half lotus, you'll fold forward over your bent knee and reach around to find the toe. Once you have your toes, sit nice and tall. Again, push with the left. Pull with the right, twist. And close your eyes. Imagine you can spiral around the absolute center of your spine. Sitting bones are heavy, the spine keeps lengthening up. Change sides. The right leg is straight, left foot on the inner thigh, or left foot in half lotus. So either reaching around to bind your foot, place the hand behind you. The right palm is up. Push your hand on the back of the thigh. Open the chest and twist. Soften the space behind your eyes. Feel that the awareness is falling back behind the eyes. Closer and closer to your center. And break the pose. And do one
twist each direction. So if you have a full lotus, you'll bring your left foot into lotus first, and then place the right foot on top and do the same thing. You'll reach around in the right foot, or maybe you can reach towards the heel, push with your hand and twist. Or repeat exactly what you just did. Left leg is straight, right foot inner thigh, right hand is behind. Shoulders open, turn. We often have a mental limit in our twists. We twist to a point where we feel that that's the end. Imagine if it's possible to twist all the way around. Keep breathing. Especially breathe into the left side of your body. Feel the left side of your body wrapping around you. Change sides. So lotus, change your lotus. Now the right foot comes up first. The left foot comes on top. You'll reach around, find your toes, your ankle. Push and twist. Or, from here, hand is on the ground. Press and open. I really like to focus on the spiritual heart in the asana. Yogis say, right in the center of the chest, spiritual heart. In the Bhagavad Gita, it's described as being a light brighter than 1,000 suns. So imagine there is a light in the center of your chest, even if you imagine it brighter than 1 sun. It's quite amazing. And feel that that light travels up and down your spine, through your arms, through your legs. So you are a channel. And this beautiful light to travel through and to be expressed through. And the things that stop how much of this light flows out of us are our fears, the attachments in the mind. Right now, allow all those to be there, but go behind them, radiating light. Break the pose. Final shavasana. Lie down on your backs. Get as comfy as you can. If you need some support for your lower back, you may wish to have a pillow or bolster under the knees. Take some of the excess curve up. Arms up to the sides. And get really comfortable. Allow the bottom teeth to fall away from the top teeth. The mouth might be slightly open. Feel all the little bones of the face and the skull relaxing. Need more space. The head. Relax the throat and neck. And feel this softening dripping down the throat right into the heart and the lungs. Feel that the heart and lungs are completely relaxed. Soften the chest and the shoulders. Upper arms become heavy, sinking down. Elbows loosen. Relax the forearms, the wrists, the hands. All the fingers, maybe becoming aware of the gentle pulse through the fingertips, through the palms, very subtle vibrations within. Feel your intention.
surrendering to the support beneath it. Just for a moment, letting go of any need to control, relaxing and accepting the support. Back can feel truly held. Pelvis and the abdomen soften. All the internal organs come into a state of perfect balance. Relax the hips and the seat. Eyes are heavy. Soften the knees, the lower legs. Relax the ankles, feet, and all your toes. Imagine that the entire body is transforming into light. Infinite specks of light and vibration. In the space around you, nothing but light. The floor, space above and below, light and vibration. Becoming one with everything. Start to deepen the breath. Stretch the arms and legs any way that you wish, whatever is comfortable to you. And gently roll to one side. Come to a seated position for a very short meditation. Sitting up tall, you can bring your hands over your heart like this. One hand comes to your shoulder, the other comes to the opposite shoulder. Allow the palms to be really soft and receptive so you can almost feel the current of your heartbeat flowing through your palms, traveling back in. And in times of uncertainty, sometimes the physical body doesn't feel safe as it navigates change. The true self, who we really are, is always safe. Mentally repeat. We'll start, we'll repeat mentally, then we'll whisper, and then silently say, may I feel safe? I'll whisper, may I feel safe? Mentally. to yourself,
I am safe. And mentally from your heart, I am safe. Thank you everyone for practicing.